Praise God. Now today is Friday. Listen, and this is the month of December, the last month of the year. Are you ready? Are you ready for God to restore all things to you? Praise God. Now that's what He's doing. And listen, and that's why I'm inviting you tomorrow, Saturday and Sunday at the Zeus Paradise Hotel along Mabushi near Setrako. You can miss this meeting if you're in the city of Abuja. And then we also stream online. So if you're not in Abuja, if you're in Abuja, listen, just find your way and come there. Praise God. But if you're not, you can follow us on Facebook and on YouTube. You'll see the streaming. You'll get a notification for when the streaming will start. It's by 5:30 p.m. on Saturday and on Sunday. Let's get immersed in God's truth. Praise God. Now, I've been talking to you about how to know and understand the Word of God. So, I was reading James chapter 3. Now, we're in verse 15. It says, "This wisdom does not descend from above, but it is earthly, sensual, demonic." See, now watch this. For where envy and self-seeking is, you know what self-seeking is? Strife. That's what strife is. So what is strife? Strife is when you insist your way is right. Yeah. So you're causing strife. So someone else is trying to do something. Say, no, it must be done this way. I think this is the best way to do it. Now, there is a way to communicate that without strife. And sometimes you allow things to work. You allow things to go. But when you insist that it must be your way, and then, oh, it must be, and then self-seeking comes in. So it says, where there's envy and self-seeking exists, confusion and every evil thing are there. Did you see that? Where there's envy and strife, there is what? Confusion and every evil thing you can think about. So listen, when there's envy in your heart, when there's strife in your heart, you go before the Lord, say, Father, these people are trying me. Father, give me power to deal with them so that they will know that you are God. So that they will know that anything you hear is not from the heart of God. Now, that can even open you up for demons to speak to you. Oh, yes. And at that moment, when you hear the voice of demons, you may just think that this is God that have spoken to me. God will never support strife. No. Let me tell you the truth. If there's strife in your heart and God speaks, the first thing He'll deal with is strife. So He may just give you rhema and say, go and give that person a gift. Ah, no way. How? No, me. Go. Never. Lord, no. You don't understand, Lord. You're telling God He doesn't understand. He's understanding. And you're telling Him you don't understand. All right. Praise God. So, listen, clear your heart of every envy. I'm telling you, you want to hear God? You want to understand God? Clear your heart from every envy. Clear your heart from every strife. Bring yourself to that place of humility. That's what you do. When you approach God, and you know, I was talking to you about sorcery the other day. When you approach God, you don't approach Him to do what you want. You approach Him first to know what His mind is. That's why I always say this. When you want to pray concerning anything, the first prayer point you should raise is, Lord, how do I go about this situation? How do I pray about this? Because the Holy Spirit has been given to us so that He will give us utterance when we pray. So you say, Lord, how do I go about this issue? And then you wait for the Spirit of God to tell you, you know what? Pray like this. All right. I have had that experience severally, and I saw miracles instantly. Yeah, I want to pray concerning something. I say, Lord, so what do I say, Lord? What do I pray? And I hear the voice of the Lord speak to me. I say, pray like this or say these words. And then the moment I say, sometimes those words bring wisdom. It brings knowledge. And I had never thought about this. Praise God. So now watch this. It says, but the wisdom that is from above is first pure. See, the wisdom there is the word of God that is from above. No, the word that comes from His mouth. Remember, it says, man shall live by every word that proceeds, continuous, present continuous, that proceeds from the mouth of God. Now, it says, every word of God that proceeds from above is first pure. Listen, it is pure, it is peaceable, it is gentle, It is willing to yield. Listen, God never, God is not the one that, you know, say, but God said this. I insist it must be like this. Listen, when God tells you this is what to do, you believe it. Now, when you try to share it with others, say, this is what God wants us to do. They may oppose you. They may fight you. Don't fight them. Just say, it's okay. Step aside. Let them do what they want to do. But don't let them make you do against what God has said to you. She just said, you know what? You guys can go ahead and do what you want. It's fine. And then you step back and say, Father, I ask for your mercy, and that they will know that your word has come and it is true. Remember to pray for them. And what prayer? That the mercy of God will rest upon them. Not because, see, because you don't want to show to them that you are the man of God and that you have heard God. No. That's not the reason. You just, you know, this is what the Lord has said. And they may argue with you. They may, fine, do what you want. Always allow people to do what they like. Praise God. But you see, the secret behind this is because you are behind praying for them. Do you understand that? You are behind praying for them and you believe that you've heard the voice of God. Let me tell you what's going to happen. They are going to come back to you and say, oh, you know what? We were wrong. And I think, let's try that your method. And then you say, okay, do it like that. It works. I say, wow, we wish we had listened to you from before. Now, you are going to make them learn to listen to you. But when you strive with them, no, it must be like this, must be like this, must be like this. And then finally, there's strife, there's arguments, there's fighting. And then they do it and they fail. They may not want to come back to you, not because they didn't think you were right, but because your own is too much. You understand? You know, like, look, let's just, instead of this guy, no. So learn, like he says, the wisdom of God is willing to yield. It doesn't mean it's willing to compromise. There's a difference between letting people, not forcing on people, and compromising. No. He said, you know what? You do it your way. You know, just do it your way. Since you insist that that's you go ahead and do it your way. But I'm going to do it this way. Don't even say, let's see which one will work. No, not in strife. You know, you understand? Just go ahead. And then you step aside and say, Father, can you just show them mercy? That's the heart of wisdom. Praise God. It says it's full of mercy and good fruits. It's not boastful. It says it is without partiality and without hypocrisy. Did you see that? I guess we're going to continue somehow with this next week, because I've got to stop here. You know what? I pray. Look at the scriptures again. Look at the scriptures again. And let the Spirit of God guide your thoughts and your mind. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I'll see you tomorrow. If you're living in the city of Abuja, I really want to see you tomorrow. Praise God. The address and everything is on the screen. Have a fruitful day and weekend. Bye-bye.